Often considered the least effective, the Great House intelligence service in the Inner Sphere, SAFE was the intelligence agency of the Free Worlds League. This reputation was gained in part due to several high-profile failures and internal divisions within the organization. Nevertheless, the SAFE did manage to carry out several successful operations against its neighbors, the Lyran Commonwealth and the Capellan Confederation, and the organization was particularly adept at political and economic intelligence gathering and analysts. Originally, the National Intelligence Agency, or the League's first intelligence agency, through the formation of the Free Worlds League, resulted in a combination of strategic resources under a single authority. Fear that the League would not prove to be long-lived meant its member states heavily resisted disbanding their individual agencies in favor of a single central government agency. The limitations and logistical problems of having six different agencies came to a head during the Captain General Julio Merrick's war against the Stuart Confederacy, the Merrick helping to narrowly push through a bill in August 2317 to create a single unified Free Worlds League intelligence bureau overseen by the Minister of Intelligence in peacetime and by the Captain General during the crisis. From its formation, the NIA conducted both internal and external operations, attracting a reputation during its first few centuries of its existence for its fastidious research, detective work, and analysts more so than the brutality or the romanticized image of a debonair spy. By post-reunification war era, however, the NIA had developed into an extremely closely knit organization that considered itself a society unto itself, using its abilities to hide and cover up its excesses. The NIA's abuses finally came to light when the release of the NIA unmasked by former NIA Director of Intelligence Shannon Cantrell, revealing that, for example, the NIA Accounting Division prepared two sets of internal costings from 2588 to 2631, one for internal use and one for the Parliament's Oversight Committee. And with even the organization itself unaware of every operation its voracious cells enacted. That scandal arising from these extra-legal activities led Parliament to revoke the organization's century-old charter in 2631, which led to the formation of SAFE and the Scourge of Death. SAFE acronym has been described as an obscure phrase in forgotten languages, the meaning of which has been long lost. And don't quote me on this, but there is at least one novel out there that actually puts down the words search and find everything. Although my understanding is that the later revisions of the novel has removed that to return it to this obscure phrase in a forgotten language, meaning of which has been lost, belief. So that's just kind of one of those things that they did. In 3081, with the dissolution of the Free Worlds League, several successor states appeared, each maintaining its own version of SAFE. When we look at the organization, the head of the intelligence agency was the director of SAFE, who answered to the captain general and a paramilitary intelligence oversight committee. In turn, each of these three major branches of SAFE was headed by an assistant director. Each branch was further subdivided into regional offices, which oversaw the affairs either within one of the other great houses or within major regions of the league, or the minor houses of the league. Although each branch has its own separate reporting structure for practical purposes, most SAFE field offices include elements of all three and appointed one person to oversee all activities within that region. So we start with the analyst branch. The subdivisions is analyst. The analyst branch is the largest of three branches with its main headquarters on Atreus. It oversaw all foreign and domestic intelligence gathering operations and had offices spread across the entire league. The analyst branch worked closely with the FWLM counterpart Military Intelligence Directorate and in later years with the Word of Blake's Wrong. The branch was divided into two major sub-departments, information gathering being the first. The largest, most pervasive of the SAFE sub-departments, information gathering, or IG, has agents on every league world and on many foreign worlds. For the most part, these agents are passive, part-time information collectors who maintain a second occupation while monitoring local news or the latest cultural developments. Shell companies were created so that some individuals weren't even aware they were working for SAFE. There existed a smaller core of dedicated intelligence operatives charged with the active infiltration and subversion of enemy organizations, but the majority of these tasks were given over to covert operations branch. The myth that IG agents were poor team players grew from the fact that many worked alone. Second part is active analyst. The second of the analyst branch sub-departments, active analyst is responsible for investigating the reported data submitted by the IG and on occasion directing their further efforts. The main office on Atris was responsible for analyzing overall trends, while regional offices on important worlds such as Andrea, Tamaran, Stuart, and Orient focused on particular issues such as events within a given region or economic developments. Working in small teams, AA agents were methodical and highly competent. Indeed, active analyst was one of the best at their job compared to any other similar department within the InterSphere's other intelligence agencies, even Comstar's ROM. Their only shortcomings were the fact that they had to rely on SAFE's other branches to gather intelligence for them, and that they were dependent on the willingness of the League's leaders to listen to them when they found something worth the note. Bring us to covert operations. Covert operations tasked the wide range of covert actions within and without the League, from infiltration to assassination, often working in concert with IG sub-department and the military's own special operations unit. The range of activities were undertaken by covert ops included sponsoring terrorist organizations within other Great House's territory, a policy which continued long after the Klan invasion when it was officially discontinued. Covert operation agents tended to work in small teams by themselves, but were also two larger units within the department. The Eagle Corps. The Eagle Corps was SAFE's special forces team on par in skill and equipment with the Federated Sons MI6 and the Draconis Combine's DEST. Numbering in three companies of elite commandos drawn from the best of the FWLM and law enforcement agencies, Unofficially never existed but became something of an open secret after a string of successes in the years after the Klan invasion. Their headquarters, the Eyrie, is built on Atreus Moon and guarded by a special detachment of Xenoplanetary Infantry. This heavily fortified sanctuary could also function as a command center in the event that Atreus' system was invaded. The Dark Shadows. Dark Shadows are an independent battle mech battalion operated by SAFE for missions requiring additional firepower. Its members were the elite of the FWLM, who were seconded to the unit, usually between 18 and 24 months at a time. Like the Eagle Corps, the unit was officially didn't exist, but leaked information helped to color Dark Shadows' public perception with myth and misdirection, and helped inspire us a series of television programs allegedly based on their operations. Counterintelligence. Charged with defending against both foreign and domestic threats, counterintelligence, or the CI branch, was the most secretive of the three SAFE divisions. What was known about CI gave the public the impression that its primary task was rooting out foreign agents and saboteurs, particularly from the Lyran and Capellan realms. Few counterintelligence agents were even public about their role as mole hunters, hoping to cultivate a deterrent effect, although most maintained a double life to hide their activities. While hunting down foreign agents is one of their missions, counterintelligence's main focus was domestic threats to the League's security and its own citizens. For the longest time, this focus fell particularly on the problematic governments of Andrian and Regulus, known hotbeds of agitation and rebellion. In the years after the Klan invasion, however, CI shifted investigation members. House Merrick itself were seen as opposing Captain General Thomas Merrick. Right? And they are also known to recruit from Our Lady Maria Auxiliary Dora Preparatory School, among other things, right? So, what we're talking about is, for the longest time, before the Klan Watch shows up, the SAFE is considered probably the worst of the InterSphere Great House's intelligence services. Spending, of course, we're back to that full circle. It applies to all the houses in general. All houses have strengths and weaknesses depending on what scenario roles are being put into. So we'll make the argument that within the SAFE itself, the organization is pretty potent. Its biggest handicaps in a lot of ways is its own government. The government is divided between the parliament and the captain general. So the captain general controls SAFE and gives them the orders to do this and that and expectations, sets the parameters for which they're supposed to operate in, and then they get their funding, of course, from the parliament, who then also has its own agenda, sometimes to weaken the captain general's position by giving him this opportunity to change things down and change things up. So when we look at that sort of stuff, we're looking at things that really make and play an important role in how this thing works out. One of the interesting notes about SAFE, and when you look at their headquarters, for example, it's a literal Star League era fortress that actually includes naval grade, ship grade defenses. So this was not something that would be easily rolled over and taken hostage or conquered. You would need to literally bring warships in to pound it into a submission. And it's because it talks about headquarters known as the Citadel lies within a forest 30 kilometers from Atreus City. Concrete and steel mock medieval fortress complex serves as the nerve center for the entire SAFE organization. Eight bunkers surround the vast castle, each bunker 5 kilometers from the complex and connected by maglev cars and access tunnels huge enough to accommodate battle mechs. Each bunker contains naval weapons for anti-vessel fire holds and a battalion of SAFE mech warriors and pilots, all whom use the most recent mechs produced by the League's factories. Currently using designs provided by the Word of Blake and SAFE as of the printing of this book. SAFE boasts better battle mech defenses than any other house intelligence agency. The bunkers serve as a ring defense around the Citadel, which itself is defended by additional mech regiment and a vast array of anti-aircraft and anti-mech weapons. Right? So, I mean, it is not something to take and just take lightly if you're going to muck with it. So, toward the end of the FedCom, so in the 3060s, after the invasion of the clans, and more importantly, the schism that occurs within the Comstar itself creates this element where a lot of Word of Blake, a lot of ROM agents and stuff are Word of Blake believers. And they go with Word of Blake. And they set up shop in the Free Worlds League, which in some ways they become direct competition with SAFE, and other ways they become augmentative and supportive of SAFE, actually helping to increase SAFE's ability to do a lot of the stuff that before was considered it's one of its weaker parts. The strongest part for SAFE in general is its analyst division and its intelligence gathering, and that means that the eyes to ears portion of an intelligence ministry, they are as good as or better than any of their Inner-Sphere contemporaries, and loads above anything that the Clan Watch can produce. Their only rival would be ROM, and in some cases they actually supersede ROM in their effectiveness, because they're not hindered by some cultural biases that come with being a indoctrinated neo-cultist. So they're not blind to some realities that the ROM agents may very well be. There's another component within SAFE that they don't talk a whole lot about that brings up that of all the Inner Sphere intelligence ministries, SAFE actually has some of the best Q sections around. When it comes to gizmos, gadgets, and fantastic toys for the 007s out there, SAFE has the top notch next to, once again, possibly ROM, because ROM has access to Star League era technology and items that were produced at the height of the Star League, which would no longer be in production. Micro technology, mini robots, things like this are all within the potential possibility. So the idea that that SAFE is the weakest of all the Inner Sphere intelligence services is probably woefully doing them an injustice. The other weakness, though, is the fragmentation of, even before the breakup of the Free Worlds League, after the Jihad or during the Jihad era, we're looking at this issue with the divisions within the house itself. So you have 6 to 8 major minor houses and scores, probably 100 plus minor houses and governmental bodies that all want to maintain their own versions of SAFE, or all have tapped into SAFE at one level or another. This can cause some internal derision and confusion and combat. So when civil wars break out, this is detrimental to these kind of organizations, because either they're going to sit on the fence and not support either side, or they're going to support one side or the other, and which gives that side ideally a major advantage. But more commonly, what happens is you see a breakdown along the lines of the supporters within the organization. So civil wars within SAFE, amongst SAFE, is not unheard of. either. They don't speak about it a lot, but it's there, and it gets mentioned once in a blue moon in the lore. So when we're looking at these organizations, and I look at, and I intend, like I said, this is my second in this series of doing this, and I'm planning to address all the major versions of these intelligence services and stuff. It's just that you really have to kind of weigh just how effective and how important intelligence services are and what their goals and what their jobs are. So when we look at organizations like the Stealthy Foxes or the Rabid Foxes from House Davion or the Internal Security Forces, DEST, Commandos, who are almost a ninja quality, and even within that organization, within the ISF, they actually do have yet another series of ninja-like organizations and commando units that are not DEST and are quite adept at getting what their job done is, or whatever job that they're being assigned to. Aggressively speaking, proactively speaking. That's not to say that SAFE's intelligence operatives aren't capable of that level of stuff. We know that they are, just they're just not known for it, and they don't pursue that aggressive forward stance as much. They're more about laying the groundwork for understanding and knowledge. So when we talk about analysts, they understand and they watch and they observe, and then they look at what they're seeing and they put the pieces together to form a really colorful puzzle that then they turn over to their leadership, ideally in the hands of the Captain General, to give them the most informed information they can have at the given time. Of course, like any agency, any group, you're only as good as the people at the top who pay attention to what everybody else is telling them. So if the Captain General or his senior advisors who are being told this is the potential thing that's coming down the street are ignoring it or blowing it off or poo-pooing it or whatever, well, that's just where that's going to roll out. It's just, they can only be as good as the people who pay attention and make use of their talents and their abilities. So, like I said, search and find everything. Yeah, right. Going on, my friends, this is Rick, and hey, if you like the channel, please hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, tell your buddies, tell your friends, tell your